Hi guys, welcome again. My name is Vishesh and you're watching Web Toddler. If you're new to the channel, so in this channel we talk about development on Flutter and all about the basics of it, and I help you through a simple videos how to get the basics of it right. In this video we are going to talk about alert dialog. So on this screen you will see the final thing, final app that we are going to make today. So it is a very simple thing. So we are just trying different dialogues here. So alert dialog, Cupertino alert dialog, and dialog. So I'll just show you the difference here. So when I click this, it calls upon a function and tells me that this is a demo, and I can just click on approve to dismiss this, right? This is a dialog box wherein I need to click on a button to basically get rid of it. I cannot click out of it. I cannot click out of this box to get rid of it, or on this box I'll just have to click on this button. So this is used for mainly to basically start the application. If you have a explicit content, so you can make them agree that you're 18 or above, and if there's any agreement that you have, you can simply click on that. Then comes Cupertino alert dialog. So this dialog is basically the one that you see on iOS. It has two buttons, you can customize it, and the user will have to click on either of these buttons to get rid of it. You cannot just click out of it, and you can configure that as well. I'll just show you how to do that. And this is a simple dialog. So simple, this is a simple dialog alert, which basically can be used to tell showcase a warning or showcase some functionality of the app with this. So you can even use it to tell the user that you're connected to internet or not. And in this one, you can click on it, but nothing happens. But when you click out of it, so it disappears. You can also configure floating action button to display a dialog, right? So we'll jump right into it. So if you are here just for the code, so always you can find it in the description link. So there'll be a link to my blog Web Toddler, and then you can go and simply copy paste the whole code that you would need. In case you would want to know more about it, so what we are going to do in this video is we are not covering the UI element, because it is pretty much the same that you get when you create a new Flutter package. So the boilerplate will remain almost same. I'll just show you the difference. So difference will be that there are three buttons, raise button that I've created, except apart from the usual counter text that you see here. That's all the difference. And secondly, the icon of the floating action button is changed. So I'll just skip right over to the place where we are completed with the UI, but we'll be writing the whole code for alert dialog. So right guys, now the UI boilerplate is ready for us. So I'll show you what exactly is done here. So I did not deliberately import the Cupertino package. It got imported with the Cupertino alert dialog when we'll write it. So when you start writing it, it will automatically import that for you. So this remains same. So my app stateless widget, and so this is the basic thing that comes with the basic boilerplate. So it remains same, everything remains same. The only difference is in the body here. So what we have done is in the column we have created raise buttons on click, which one will right now they're doing nothing, it's just null. That is the reason you see them inactive here. And so we have given them a text to basically get an idea: alert dialog, Cupertino alert dialog, and normal dialog. And then for floating action button also we have kept it null for now, and we have changed the icon here to info, right? So let's just start writing it. So I'll tell you one thing beforehand. So this alert dialog is not a widget that we are going to create. It's already a pre-built widget. The only thing that we are going to do here is write a function to show it. So it's a future function that we are going to write here, because it is in the future that we will see it once it is clicked. So we're giving it a name of show alert dialog, and it will be an async function. Now we are returning show dialog. Wait. we'll give it a context. So the context will be the current context that we have. And this is barrier dismissible. So this is where you define if a user can click outside the dialog box and dismiss it. So if we create it, if we type it as false, the user will not be able to basically exit it out when user taps outside the dialog. Right now we'll have a builder context. So builder context will come here. Build context will be context. This will return a error dialog. So you see that's already a pre-built widget. So it takes an argument like title. So you can click, you can go here and click Control Q or Command Q to get exactly the arguments that it take to get a definition of it. So the title can be, say, it's a text again, text widget, alert dialog. Next we'll give it a content. So in content we can give it if the content is longer, we can give it a single child scroll view. Here we'll just keep it simple to text. This is an alert dialog, right? And then we come to actions. So now we'll type in actions here. Actions are nothing but the buttons that we see in the dialog box. So it's a widget and then it's a list of widgets, you can say. So we'll give it at a flat button, which is a child of text. Okay. On pressed. So for now we'll just pop it. Now we give it up. Dot pop. So guys, we have our first dialogue ready with us. So you have seen that it is very easy to show a alert dialogue, and I'll show you how to show it. So it is like, so we have created this function and we'll be calling this function here. So underscore show alert dialog, right? When we hot reload it, so you'll see that the first button will get activated. So we can see it here, and when I click on this, I see a alert dialog. So what I'll do is I'll simply show you how others are made. What I'll do is I'll just copy it. You'll see how easy it is. What I'll do is I'll change the name here. Cupertino alert dialog and show dialog. Right? For Cupertino, what we are going to do is we'll keep almost everything same. So we'll we'll be writing Cupertino dialog, Cupertino alert dialog. Yeah, that's what we are going to write here. Cupertino alert dialog. And we can change the content here. Again, Cupertino. Cupertino alert dialog. Right. In case of actions, so there's a little change here that you'll see. In case of actions, what we are going to do is, we're going to remove this flat button and instead we are going to write Cupertino dialog action. I'm going to give it a child of text that we want to display. So yes and no are coming here, and then we define what it does on REST. Right, so we can simply do it again, navigator dot context dot pop, and similarly we can just copy paste and comma here. No, so we have our Cupertino widget ready as well, Cupertino alert dialog in fact. So now we come to show dialog. So this is a simple dialog that we are showing here. So in this we will not keep any button there. What we are going to keep is we are going to simply display the information, and when somebody clicks out of it, we'll be dismissing of the screen. So we are doing away with the actions here. So actions is a optional criteria that we need to mention, right? And then yes, pretty much everything is done. We just convert it true, but you must tap outside the alert dialog, right? And now we are just changing what a raise button does on click. So in this Cupertino, and another one, show dialog. And yes guys, floating action model we also will be displaying show dialog. And when I hot reload it, you'll see the app is written the same that we started with. So when I click on Cupertino alert dialog, it gives me a Cupertino style alert dialog. I can click on yes, I can, when I click outside it, it is not disappearing. Similarly with dialog, so it simply displays the information, and when I click inside the dialog, it does not dismiss it. When I click outside it, it is dismissing it. Similarly with the floating action button, the same is happening here. So guys, this is pretty much it about show alert dialog. So alert dialogs are very useful and very subtle things that you would want to put in your app. And just let me know guys what next you would want to see from my end. And this is pretty much for this video.